Today we talk about a call to praise. A call to praise. And we're going to read Psalm 145. And because of our time, we'll just read through not much of explanations. But I pray that God bless you. For anything you need the notes, let me know. The notes are going to be available. You can just have the notes, you can read them and meditate on them on your own. But for today, we'll just read through what I have here. Psalm 145, where let me get the new version of my system here. Psalm 145. Can we please read together? Are we ready?
Yes.
We are going to read the whole of Psalm 145. Let's go. I will exalt thee, my God, O King, and I will bless thy name forever and ever. Every day will I bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. One generation shall praise thy works to another, and shall declare the mighty acts. I will speak of the glorious honor of thy majesty and the wondrous works, and men shall speak of the might of the terrible acts, and I will declare thy greatness. They shall abundantly utter the glory of the greatness, and shall sing of the righteousness. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and great mercies. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. All my God shall praise thee, O Lord, and that he shall bless thee. They shall speak of the glory of thy goodness and talk of thy power to make known to the sons of men his mighty acts and the glorious majesty of his kingdom. The kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and the dominion endureth throughout all the nations. The Lord upholdeth all that fall, but listen to all about them. The eyes of all wait upon thee, and thou givest them the need in due season. Thou openest the heart, and inspire the desire of every living. The Lord is righteous in all his ways, and holy in all his purposes. The Lord is nigh to all them that call upon him, to all that call upon him in truth. He will fulfill the desire of them that fear him. The Lord preserveth all them that love him, and all the wicked destroyed. My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord. Let all the flesh dwell, bless his holy name forever and ever. What is the discussion again? The theme is what? A call to praise. A call to what? To praise. And I pray that nothing will limit us in praising God.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
But we said David wrote this psalm, which is full of praises and the reasons why we should praise God. And he ended up, he rounded up this this chapter by making a personal declaration and a commitment that he is going to praise God forever and ever. Verse 2 says, every day I will bless you and I will praise your name forever and ever. Verse 34, Psalm 34 verse 1, David also said, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually what? Be in my mouth. I will do what? I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Can we say, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be mine. For the last time, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I pray that the praise of God will not cease.
Amen.
In your mouth, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, if the praise of God ceases in our mouth, something is wrong somewhere. Not in our mouth, but in our system, inward. Because out of the abundance of the heart,
the mouth
speaks. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Tell your neighbor, I will not allow any defeat in my heart. Say very well, I will not allow any defeat in my heart. Because I am more than a conqueror. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why do you praise God? From what we have read, just a summary of what we have read so far. You can follow. But like I said, if you need the notes, they'll be available. Samuel said, God is great, God is good, God is merciful, our provider is glorious, is honorable, is majestic. He said, God is righteous, is slow to anger. The psalmist tells us, God is gracious, full of compassion. He does wondrous works. His kingdom is everlasting, his dominion is forever. He upholds all that fall, raises up all those that are bowed down. He satisfies the desire of every living thing, righteous in all his ways, and holy in all his works. He is near unto all them that call upon him in truth. And of course, lastly, we are a choosing what? A choosing generation, according to 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. Praise the Lord. Now, talking about praise, the psalmist is telling us of who God is, what God has done, what God is doing, and what God will do. God is capable of doing all of these things at the same time because God is great. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As his blessing here, his healing here, his providing a husband here, his delivering from accident there, and is promoting someone somewhere, and is establishing business. So God is great. He can do all things at the same time in a very powerful way. Amen?
Amen.
Your God will not be weak.
Amen.
I say your God will not be weak.
Amen.
Your God will not be late.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 If all of us are writing exams, God can help all of us at the same time. And if it's a blessing, God can release blessings according to our needs at the same time. As God is speaking to us here, he's speaking all over the world. God is great. That's what Simon said, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. We are choosing to praise him. If nothing else, that summarizes why we existed. And also summarizes what the psalmist was saying. We are choosing to praise him. 1 Peter 2 verse 9. 1 Peter 2 9 says, you are what? A choosing generation. A royal priesthood. A holy nation. I say his own special people peculiar. That you may proclaim the praises of him. Hallelujah. Tell yourself, I'm choosing to proclaim what? His praises. So at the end of the day, ask yourself, how have I praised God today? And if you have left off praising God, if some other things have taken place, which is natural to every human being, we can go back again. Amen?
Amen.
We can what? We can go in the default. Say, I am created what? To praise. Tell your problem, I'm created to praise. So you can't override what the scripture says. Amen?
Amen?
Tell yourself, I'm created to praise God. And nothing can rob me of praising God. The church is established and filled with men that are refined by God. I have told us, some of us are far, far, far more better than our colleagues at work. Amen? Whether EQ or IQ. They call it emotional intelligence or whatever. Come on up with different cardinal or something, what? Emotional what?
Intelligence.
Praise the Lord. So you can praise God. Don't be ashamed. When you want to eat, you are looking at it. Are you looking at me?
No.
In the public, God bless your food. If I shout Jesus, let them hear. Praise God.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, I will not be ashamed.
I will not be ashamed.
Of Jesus.
Of Jesus.
In the public.
In the public.
And I will not lose my smell in the church.
I
will not lose my smell. You just be like, praise the Lord.
Amen.
The kingdom of God. So whether it's true praise or true prayer or true fasting, you have to be alive. You have to be alert. You have to be involved. To what? To be inclusive in heavenly blessing.
Amen.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. I went to embassy, they refused pizza to one of my kids. I said, no way. Who bomb monkey? You give me pizza in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Those that know their God, they shall what? They shall be strong. And the what? They shall do, you will do exploit in Jesus' name. Exploit in Jesus' name. Exploit in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I was the president on the campus. I put my banner somewhere. The blacks asked, they went and ruined my campus. I said, no way. They say, don't fight them. I just came from the military. How will you not fight? In the verse, amen. I said, no way. I'm serving a living God. You are serving a living God. We are serving a living God. I said, no way. Go and remove it by fire, by force. And put my banner there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
At the end of the day, because God stood by us. They came with compassion, they came with all kind of faith, they couldn't do us anything, amen?
Amen.
There's power in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
If you are willing to explore,
yes.
Amen?
Yes.
If you are willing to just little sacrifice, wake up and pray, wake up and pray. Look beyond the problem and look at the problem solver, amen?
Amen.
And praise. I say, I know my Redeemer lives. I will not die in this circumstance. Rather, it's a stepping stone. I begin to rejoice in the Lord. It's not easy, but you have to muster faith and encourage yourself in the Lord like David did. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Tell your neighbor, you can bounce back. I'm not saying you are falling, but you can what? You can bounce back through praise. I think I should get out of the way, yeah, so we can praise Him. Hallelujah. To praise God is to celebrate. To celebrate is to rejoice in God your Maker. To praise God is to celebrate. So as we're going to praise Him today, let us put on the garment of celebration. Let's rejoice. God delights in the praise of His people. He's so happy that it's a group of people that are not consumed with things of this world. They are focusing on Him and are rejoicing in the God they don't see. Some of them have challenges and issues that they're dealing with, but then they put that aside and they're focused on Him. The Bible says, God will inhabit your praise.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. I said, God will what? Inhabit your. Whether you say amen or not, it's really the scriptures.
Yeah.
And where God inhabits, the Bible says, there is fullness of what? Of joy and pleasures forevermore. Hallelujah. Darkness must not rule over us.
Yeah.
Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
Witches and wizards are not greater than Jesus. If Christ is in you and is the hope of glory, our lives will go from one level of glory to what? To another. Are you listening to me? And when you begin to praise Him, that glory comes upon you. If you praise Him here, in your closet, in the kitchen, wherever you go, say, just give God the praise, you will see more of His glory. Amen?
Yeah.
And where glory comes, there is honor. If you go to your office and you are glorious, they just look at you and promote you. Say, ah, this one, there's something special about this. When would you see a glorious man, they bow. Huh? Say, Jesus, have you come to drive us out there? They duck. You know how they duck? Because Jesus carries glory. May you carry glory.
Amen.
May you carry glory.
Amen.
May you carry anointing.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise is rejoicing. And celebrating, to celebrate is what? Is to rejoice. Be glad, be happy, sing at the topmost of your voice. Move your lips and rejoice in God. If we say there's a record, then there's a record of that. And it's stored in heaven. And when there's a problem, God will remember the fellow who praised him and said, Death, you dare not touch Sister Helen. How many Helens are there? There's one Helen. Praise the Lord. The one here said, you know, not even responding. Praise the Lord. Amen. Okay. Touch not my anointed, and do my prophets no harm. You may not be prophetic in the literal sense. Hey, God says the Lord. Next day you win a million. No, I can't do that. You're going to be a man and woman who is absorbing the glory through praise, who is honoring God and giving him the food he likes. The food he likes, as you praise him, as if you are feeding God. You are feeding God. And when God is fed, when your heavens are loaded, the rain will fall and nothing will stop your rain.
Yeah.
Your promotion will come.
Amen.
Nothing will stop your promotion.
Amen.
Your husband will locate you.
Amen.
Your wife will locate you if you are not married. That's a question of age. We have 50 years old who just delivered children. Your children will come, whatever the age, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's by fire, by what? By force.
Amen.
And if you praise God now, you are young, you are a student, God will make a way for you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He honors those what? Who honor him.
Hallelujah.
Celebrate. Psalm 149 verse 2 to 4 says, Let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Psalm 149. Let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise his name in dance. Let them sing praises unto him with what? With tambourine or timbrel and harp. That the saxophone, the keyboard, the string instrument, and all that. For the Lord taketh pleasure in his people. May God take pleasure in you in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I would say, God will beautify the meek. With what? With salvation. Bible said, 1,000 shall fall by your side, and what? 10,000 by your right hand. May God beautify you with salvation.
Yeah.
May God beautify you with salvation.
Yeah.
I would say, no evil shall come near you. No plague shall come near your dwelling.
Say,
with your eyes you shall see the reward of the wicked. You prepare ground for that. One of those that run ahead of us, I just go and sleep and say, I know my Redeemer, because you have paid your dues. You have come to church to praise him.
Yes.
Hallelujah. In the night you woke up to praise God, may God be there for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
What are the benefits? Celebration rejuvenates and connect us to the mighty God. It connects us to the heavens. It connects us to the source of all goodness, providence, and benevolence. That is, the provision of God is available. Mercy, as you praise him, the release upon you, yafu yafu. Amen?
Amen.
In abundance, that's what they call yafu. It takes us to the gates, to the courts of heaven, where there is fullness of joy and pleasures, praises. This praise you do, they just take you straight to the kingdom of God by faith. It causes the earth to yield increase and heaven to open up on us. It invites and draws God to our battles, like he did for Paul and Silas, like the wall of Jericho came down through praises. The praises of God invite God into the affairs of our lives. So when you pray, you praise him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you praise him, you pray. If I can even stop prayer and begin to praise him in advance. Amen?
Amen.
It is a weapon of offense against Satan and his agents. When we get to heaven, we are going to praise God forever. You better practice it. You better practice it now. We are going to heaven to praise. When we get there, we are going to praise God. We better practice it right now. Let us praise Him greatly today. Great is the Lord, and what? Greatly to be praised. Verse 3. Conclusion. Let us maximize all the benefits in today's thanksgiving by declaring God's greatness and goodness to us. Declare it with your mouth. And then what? Let us rejoice greatly in Him who has redeemed us and has provided and has kept us thus far. So you rejoice, you praise Him with your mouth, then you rejoice with instrument and whatever you have. It has to be done through Christ. All of us, we know that it is only Jesus that can make a way for us to the kingdom. And if you don't have Christ, it is an exercise in futility. So if you don't have Jesus, please give your life to Jesus today. Ask Him to come into your heart. Confess all your sins. He knows them all. You want to speak them to Him. And the Bible says, we'll forgive your sins and will give you for all unrighteousness. John chapter 12, 32 says, and if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men. Are you going to lift up Jesus today? Are you going to lift Him up this week? This month? This year? You'll be lifting up. The script cannot be broken. When you lift Him up, He's going to do what? He is going to lift you up. Hallelujah. Don't fold your hands. Don't be stiff in the church. You must be flexible. Left, right, center, front. Jump all around wherever you are. And rejoice in God your Maker. When David did it, and David went into sin, God forgave him before he started asking. And he's called a man after his heart. So we're going to rise. Just lift up your hands and say, Jesus, I lift you. My Maker, I lift you.